Hello friends, we are seeing fresh concrete. We are seeing the term known as what is workability. Workability is the easy with which you mix, transport, place, compact and finish the surface. We call such a concrete which you can do easily as workable concrete. Now we have said this is a type of concrete. Now how to measure the workability? Today we will see the methods to measure workability. And the most common experiment or the procedure what we use to measure workability is slump cone. Slump cone. So in this case, we use a cone like this. This is a cone. It has got upper diameter of 100 mm. It has got lower diameter of 150 mm. And the height of this is 300 mm. And this has got handles here to lift it. Got the idea? This is cool. I can lift and keep it. This is kept on a solid stand at the bottom. And it will be clamped to the base. Now here the procedure is, we'll have to make the concrete and see how much slump. Slump is nothing but fall. How much fall is taking place in the concrete. So what we do here is, we make concrete. Suppose if I use a proportion of 1:2:4. 1 cement, 2 sand and 4 aggregate. Suppose if I am using 2.5 kg of cement, then how many kg? 5 kg of sand, then 10 kg of coarse aggregate. See, the procedure is like this: cement, sand and aggregate. So if I mix all these, suppose if I take a water cement ratio of say 0.5. 0.5 means 2.5 kg cement, 0.5 means 1.25 kg of water or liter of water. We mix the proportion in a tray, then after mixing we keep this cone and with the bigger bottom and smaller at the top on a stand, we pour this concrete into this. We pour it into 1, 2, 3 or 4 layers. So we pour into first layer, we'll compact it by the compacting rod by 25 blows. Then again we'll add 1/4. Again we'll compact it by 25 blows. Again we'll add 1/4. We'll compact it by 25 blows. Then we'll fill it, compact it and level the surface. Just we'll twist the cone on the table so that it is totally perfectly level. Now what we do is, we hold the handle and lift it vertically up. We don't touch here and there. We just vertically lift it up. Now what will happen to the concrete inside? It will try to fall down. It will try to fall down. Now suppose after removing, the concrete has fallen like this. This is the cone what you have done. So it may fall like this. Slight. Now here, this was the original and this is the final. So you measure this slump. Slump is nothing but the fall in the height. So this slump will help us to decide what is the workability of the concrete. This first time I will do. Suppose if I get a slump of say 20 mm. First with water cement ratio of 0.5. Now what I will do, I will take up one more set. I will add water cement of 0.6. 0.6 means water is more. So again I will take this fresh. I will add water to that 0.6. So 0.6 of 2.5. I will mix it. Again I will pour into the cone. I will clean the cone. Again I will put 1, 2, 3, 4 layers. Each layer compacted by 25 plus. Then after that we will level the surface. Then we will lift it up. So what will happen to the slump? Will it remain same or it will fall down more? Because more water is there. Again it will fall like this. Suppose here this slump fall in the height is say 50 mm. So for 0.6 the slump is 50 mm. Like this. If I go on increasing the water cement ratio, the slump will go on increasing. As the slump goes on increasing, means it is very easy to mix. If there is no slump, means the concrete is very stiff, very difficult to mix it. So here slump will be, if slump is more, workability is good. That's the simple thing what we see. Now here, as we go on increasing the water, what will happen? The slump goes on falling. So here we get three types of slump. Suppose this is the original cone. So they will be falling like this. Or there will be, suppose this is original shape, this will completely fall like this. So as the water goes on increasing, this is the maximum water where it will collapse. Why it will collapse? Because the amount of water we added is too much. Now this type of failure we call it as shear. It is inclined, so we call it as shear failure. And this type of failure is true slump. True slump. So there are three types of slump: true slump, shear, and collapse. Collapse type of aggregate, they concrete will segregate out. The water will separate out from the ingredient. We don't usually go for collapse type of aggregate. So we prefer true slump. Now here, depending upon the type of work what we want, we will be deciding slump. I want a slump of 100 mm. So I will have to design how much water I should add so that I will get a slump of 100 mm. So that water cement ratio you will be using for the slump purpose. If I want to find 150 mm, then you have to decide how much water is to be added so that you get a slump, fall. Slump is nothing but fall in the height by 150 mm. So like this, this experiment is very easy. You can do at the site also. You can carry, it's a very handy equipment. You can take it to the site and do the slump test. And for every sample, every time you mix, you can do this slump test. So this is a very simple method of doing the slump. Usually when you go for slab, thickness is very less. You'll have to go for more workability. It should flow out because the thickness is less. If you go for column, it is going vertically. Much workability is not required there. You need to tamp it properly. If you go for roads, roads are flat. So there you need more workable concrete. If the workability is less, then it will be very difficult for you to fill up that less thickness. So if it is workable, it will start itself spreading out and it will be easy for you to compact. So depending upon the type of work, you will have to determine the workability of the concrete. This is one method, slump cone method. There is another method also, which is again very simple. It can be done in the lab or it can be done in the field also. But it is slightly heavier than the slump. So the next method is compaction factor method. Compaction factor method. Compaction factor method. So in this, we usually abbreviate as CF method. Compaction factor method. So to conduct this experiment also, we have got the apparatus known as compaction factor apparatus. So now this apparatus has got a strong base and a vertical rod. This is one piece. So to this we connect cone like this. This is just as we have seen in the slump cone. There we are using inverted, here we will be using the tapering downward direction. There will be one more here cone. I'll draw slightly bigger. One cone, two cone, and this is a cylinder. So these are fitted to the stand, fixed. This is not fixed, this is removable. So these are cone, this is also cone, and this is cylinder. Cylinder means it has got constant diameter and height of 300 mm. It is standard. Now these cones, what are there? They have got gates here, shutters. You can open and you can close it. So there is a locking element. You can open and close. There is one more shutter here also. You can lock it and open it. Just got the idea? Now here, we make concrete. For slump, suppose we are used 1:2:4. We are used 2.5 kg, 5 kg and 10 kg of coarse aggregate. We will add water to this. So suppose if I add water to this as 0.5, we make the concrete. Then what we do is, before starting the experiment, we measure the weight of cylinder, empty weight. We measure the empty weight of cylinder as W1. Now, what we'll do with the concrete what we have prepared, we'll fill it into this upper cone. It is closed, gate is closed, so concrete will be there only. Now, what we'll do, we'll remove the shutter. The moment we remove the shutter, whatever concrete is there, it will start flowing and it will fall into the lower. See, it is falling with certain standard height. So, this concrete will get stored into the lower cylinder. Now, this is also closed, it will be there only. Now, what we do? We open this gate also. So, this concrete, what is there, will completely fall into the cylinder. Then, what you do? You level the surface of the cylinder. So, the quantity of concrete will be slightly more than the size of the cylinder. So, level the surface, you take out this mold, then you take the filled weight. W2. When I take empty weight and filled weight, what is the standard weight? So this is W if I call, W2 minus W1. Filled weight minus empty weight will give the weight. So this weight what we have got is when we are making the concrete to fall with certain standard height. So we know force into displacement in the direction, same direction, we call it as work done. So force is there, it is moving in the same direction, work load is also acting vertically down. So it is doing certain amount of work, and work done is nothing but force into displacement. Now what we do is, after doing this, whatever material is there inside, we remove it out into the tray from this, which has already filled. So we remove out the material, and what we do is, we take this cylinder separately and we'll fill this cylinder in three layers. 1, 2, and 3, each layer being compacted by 25 blows. Same concrete. What is there? So this concrete will be slightly excess, I told you. So that concrete will be filling in first layer, second layer, and third layer, 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, each layer compacted by 25 blows. Now we take weight of compacted concrete. Compacted concrete. Suppose if I call this as let me give some other notation. W3, this is W4. So W3 is standard height minus fill, and this W4 is the weight of the compacted concrete. Now here we come across a term known as compaction factor. This compaction factor is nothing but W3 divided by, if I call this as W4, so W5 will be equal to W4 minus W1. Means after filling I have taken the weight as W4. So W4 is the filled weight minus W1 is the empty weight. So we will come to know how much concrete we have compacted in it. So that if I call it as W5. So W3 by W5, we call it as the compaction factor. Now this W3 is the weight of the concrete by doing certain standard work or by falling through some standard height. Whereas W5 is the weight of the compacted concrete. Definitely weight of the compacted concrete will be more than the weight of the standard falling. And this is usually less than 1. It is less than 1 only. It cannot be more than 1 because the denominator is always greater. So this method will help us. As the compaction factor changes, the workability of the concrete will also be changing. So if you get 0.9, 0.8, 0.7. So as this goes on decreasing, this denominator will go on increasing. So here the workability will be playing its role. So depending upon the compaction factor, you can decide the workability, or if you want to have this compaction factor, what is the amount of water to be added, you'll have to decide. So this is known as compaction factor method. So cones, two cones and one cylinder. So here we call this as this from road research. This has been given by road research laboratory. It is given by the road research laboratory. It says it determines the degree of compaction achieved by amount of work done by falling standard height. That's what I have told you. This is work done. It is a constant. It remains the same. Only change will be in this compactor. So here, depend upon this, it will determine the degree of compaction. This is important. It will determine the degree of compaction by standard amount of work done by filling concrete through standard method. Right? So this is about the compaction factor. So here you can call compaction factor is equal to, you can remember this ratio, CF is equal to weight of partially compacted concrete to weight of fully compacted concrete. That's what we have seen. W3 by W5, it is the weight of the partially compacted, means standard height, and weight of the fully compacted, which will be compacting with our hand. So this is another method of determining the workability. So first easy method is the slump pone method, and second is the compaction factor method. Okay, there is another method known as VB consistometer test. VB consistometer test. See, in slump is possible if it is more watery. Water cement ratio is more. In compaction also, if it has to fall, its water cement also should be more. If the water cement ratio of the concrete is less, so whenever the water cement of concrete is less, we go for VB consistometer test. So this consistometer test, it has got a vibrator. It has got a strong table. On that, these are the vibrators. Spring like. On this we keep a metal cylinder, and in this we keep a cone which can be lifted up. We have seen in the slump cone. Now here there is a vertical rod which will be very strong. This rod will be having a glass plate. This will be a glass plate, and this can be swelled. Just you can see, if this is a rod, I can rotate this like this. And this is a glass plate which is circular in shape. So I can move this left and right. It is a glass plate. And below there is a metal cylinder. In that we have kept the slump cone. And this is electrically operated. And whenever this starts, this being the spring, this starts shaking like this. And you know, whenever shaking takes place, compaction will be taking place. That is what we are going to measure in the self-compacting test. Now the procedure is what we do. We remove this or swell this. We take turn and we'll add into this cylinder concrete. So we add concrete in three layers, one third, one third, one third, each layer by 25 blows, 25 blows, 25 blows. Right? Then what we will do, we will slowly remove the cone. Now what has happened, water cement ratio is very less, so it will not slump, it will remain as it is. Now what we will do, we will bring this swell. This is a glass plate and this glass plate is transparent, so you can see through that glass plate, it is a circular glass plate. So we swell this on the surface, and suppose if this is the concrete, I removed the core, only concrete is there here. This is the concrete. Now I will keep this plate touching to this. To this sand, this sand. It is touching to the surface. Now what I will do, I will start the machine. So whenever I start the machine, this starts getting vibrated like this. Now before starting the machine, I will note down the time T1. At what time I am starting the machine. Then I will allow it to vibrate. What will happen? This concrete slowly starts falling and it will occupy the horizontal surface. As this is happening, this plate, glass plate, that also will move with the concrete, because concrete is going down, and through the plates you see that it has become completely flat. When you see through the glass it has become completely flat, stop your watch. You get time T2. So final time minus initial time will give the time it has taken to flatten from conical to cylindrical or circular shape. So this time elapsed, we call it as the VB consistometer time. So we are measuring here time. What we are measuring is in VB consistometer is the time. So procedure is very easy. This is the apparatus, it has got springs. These are usually rubber springs. We have got this in our lab. So this is a vertical stand. This is the glass which can be swivel, S-W-I-W-E-L, swivel. Can be rotated, move up and down. Now here procedure is, make concrete of standard proportion, add water to that, mix it, then fill it into this in three layers by keeping the cone in the cylindrical metal only. Now slowly lift up the core, then you touch this glass plate to the top surface before starting the machine. Note down the time. Then you start the machine, vibration. Then as the concrete will go down, along with that you loosen this part. So this glass plate will also be coming down. Through the top you go on observing. When you see the concrete is completely touching to the plate, that means it has become flat. That's why we are using glass plate, so that you can see from the top that the whole surface of the plate is touching the concrete. You stop the watch and the time elapsed, we call it as the VB consistometer time. If it is taking more time, means water cement ratio is less. If it is taking less time, immediately coming down, means water cement ratio is more. So this is a time what will be deciding what is the water cement ratio. More is the time, T is more, it is less water cement ratio. If time required is less, then it is having more water cement ratio. So this method is used whenever we are using less water cement ratio. So these are the methods that we will be employing to determine the workability: slump cone test, compaction factor test, and VB consistometer test. So these are the workability, factors affecting workability, how you measure the workability. So in next class we will see the other property of concrete. Thank you.